there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today I'm going to share with you a drawing from my sketchbook for Sketchbook Sunday, and this was the second sketchbook piece I did for the month of October. I am doing a drawing a day for, well, I'm not doing Inktober, I'm kind of doing my own thing. I'm just trying to get better at figure drawing, so I'm drawing figures every day. And I started off sketching in color erase pencil using my Virtual Pose books, and then I just kind of sketched on a little halter dress on my character here, and I thought she looked like she was dancing, so I wanted to use the halter dress to convey some movement. And here you can see me inking it up with a Micron pen. This is just a waterproof fine liner that is going to work with my watercolors on top, because I like to do, I like to be able to vary it, but I really like to do watercolors, I think, mostly in my sketchbook, because it's so easy to lay down a quick base of color. I can glaze over with watercolors, I can leave it as is, I can let the colors flow, I can get my, I like to add movement with spatters, I like to direct the eye through the painting with splashes and spatters, so a watercolor works really well, and I'm pretty fast with it, and since I'm adding this daily drawing onto my normal workload, I want to make sure it's something that I can finish each day. And I'm keeping just a variety of pens and a pen cut cup on my table so I can have everything quickly to access. I tend to go in with like a number 3-point pen and kind of vary my pressure to get different line widths. And then I can go with thicker, thinner ones if I need to. And then I went in with a big eraser, and I got that at the Dollar Tree. I've had people ask me about my big eraser and where I get it. I think they come in a 3-pack at the Dollar Tree. They're just like a blue and white wrapper on it. It's not a name brand or anything, but it works great. I really like it. It's very gentle on my watercolor paper. And I just erased my color erase pencil. The color erase pencils are the erasable pencils made by Prismacolor. They're very affordable. You can get them at any art supply store online or on Amazon very inexpensively. Now for skin tones, I like to make my skin tones with, I start off with yellow ochre, then I'll add a cool red, either like a crimson or a carmine or something that's got a cool undertone red. And then I add, to darken it, I'll add ultramarine blue and I'll also add burnt sienna. Now you can get a variety of skin tones with these four colors. You just vary the proportions of what color you need. Like if you're doing a more warmer, darker skin tone, add more burnt sienna. If you're doing a darker, cooler skin tone, add more burnt sienna and ultramarine blue to tone down the, darkness and tone down the orangeness of the burnt sienna. You can add more crimson or rose if you've got more of a fair skin tone with cool undertones. That's such a great combination for skin. I encourage you to play with those colors and see what sort of variety you can get. Now for simple highlights, I'm just going in with a damp clean brush and wiping off some of the color. For shadows, I'm adding more of the ultramarine blue, burnt sienna, heavy mix, but it's pretty much those four colors just varied in different relations. I'm using Lucas watercolors. I find them to be very easy for doing skin tones. They blend really well. They just have a very kind of traditional watercolor feel to them. They've got a very soft effect, a soft feeling to them. I always love to use them when I'm doing skin tones and when I'm doing anything where I want to have more of that kind of classic vintage watercolor look. Of course, you can do brights. You'll see that I use plenty of bright colors with them, but I like the control that I get with that color. That's the set from my signature set through Jerry's Artorama, the Lucas signature set. I'm not sure if they're back in stock, but they did just start shipping to Canada a couple weeks ago. So I do know there were some Canadian folks that were looking to pick up some supplies from Jerry's. They are shipping to Canada again. It's been so crazy getting shipments out of America, it seems like, over the past 7 months. So I like to add shadows. I feel like shadows, getting them in soon after beginning the painting process, is helpful because it weights the figure. It gives them a place to stand. It makes them feel more solid. And I like to do the spatters because I feel like this girl is dancing, and adding the spatters near the feet adds an energy. Adding the spatters at the end of the hair that's kind of whipping around adds some energy. And I just think it's kind of a technique that I like. I know it's not for everyone, but that's why I do it. It's not just random. I know a lot of people think the spattering is just random. But I do it in certain areas to add interest. Some people think it's cheating, but I like it. I like the look of it. Now, originally when I drew this dress, I realized her dress was just a little too short. So I had to give her a little slip. And plus, it's if you have a dress that has a, and this is just a tip, if you buy a dress that has a liner or a slip in it, it is going to be more flattering. I just want to put that out there, ladies, because when we're in our 20s and we have those sundresses, we don't need slips and liners because everything just stays where it belongs, right? But when you get older, anything that you can have underneath your dress that smooths things out is very helpful. So, top tip there. Spend a little bit more, buy a dress that's got a lining in it. You will thank me. Yeah, I really enjoyed sketching this figure, and I enjoyed painting it and adding the details. And honestly, I've got to say that I feel like the hard work is done in the drawing, and the fun and the play is done in the painting. And maybe you feel differently. I think before, I definitely paint more than I just sit and draw. And so I'm probably just a little bit more proficient in it. Because I know when I first started, or when I was younger and I would draw a lot, I kind of wouldn't want to paint it. I just want to spend forever shading it because if I painted it, I felt like there was way more chance of messing it up. But now I feel the opposite. I feel like I cannot wait to jump in with the color. I just want to get, I want to get my lines accurate so then I can play with the color. But everybody's different. You can let me know in the comments below if you prefer drawing or you prefer painting. I just love how I can kind of sculpt the legs. I can get that roundness and the form and the shape and the volume just by adding like layers of color, and I just find that so satisfying. Of course, you could do that with charcoal or graphite just by shading more there. And I really want to encourage you, even if like you don't have watercolors, if you've got some copy paper and you have a number two pencil, you can improve. You can create beautiful art. You do not need to spend a lot of money to improve. And that's what I love about an art challenge. It's kind of exciting and fun to go on like Instagram and see what everybody's doing for Inktober or Drawtober or Drawloween or whatever challenge they're doing, because these are people that are just trying to improve and they're not trying to show off. Well, some might be trying to show off, but I think that we all need to be improving, because if you're not improving, it's not as fun to be an artist. Because if you're just cranking out the same old all the time, you're just going to feel like you're on a hamster wheel and you're not getting anywhere. I think we all need to, when you start to feel static, when you start to feel like we're not having the growth, and we start to feel like everything we do is just safe, it's time to stretch. It's time to, take a step out on that branch, risk falling, risk failing, and create, because that's where you really start to feel the life and vitality and enjoyment in your art again. I'm using colored pencil to add some detail to my little flowers on the dress and to add a little shading. Yellow can be a real tricky color to shade. I often will use like a lavender color, but I thought that might actually, if I did that with a colored pencil, it might actually overlay, because my Prismacolor pencils are slightly opaque. So rather than glazing with a lavender, it would actually just be putting purple on top, and it wouldn't really work so well. So I did use kind of like a mossy gray color to shadow there. And when I tip the sketchbook, I'm doing that so I can see if I have my if I have it accurate or not, because if you're sitting and you're drawing with your book flat, you can get this kind of parallax distortion, and you don't realize everything's off until you look at it square on. So it's important to tip your sketchbook up. You're looking at it at a 90 at a well square on, not at a like a weird angle. I'm using some white pen to give some like highlighting, like on the shoulder, on the nose, on the cheekbone, back of the hand. That helps give the bends and the getting that reflection just helps give the helps with the volume and give you that detail. Now, I didn't feel like there was enough definition, so I'm going in with a thicker pen. I think this is like a it's either a 0.05 millimeter or 0.08 millimeter pen, and I'm just kind of outlining a little bit because I thought that I lost quite a bit of the dimension. And I gotta tell you, now this is something that's kind of interesting. I wasn't happy with this when I was finishing it up. I was kind of like, oh, what a bummer. I thought this was gonna be really good, but it's not that great. Oh well, I'm gonna post it anyway because I'm posting everything. But then the next day when I looked at the photo of this sketchbook piece, I was like, I actually like this. So sometimes it's like that. Sometimes you'll finish up a piece and all you can see is a struggle. All you can see is what you fought with about it. And then when you look at it later, you're like, and you forget about the battle, you forget about the struggle, you'll like your work. And other times you'll love it while you're doing it, and then you look back at it the next day and you cringe. It's funny being an artist, isn't it? I want to thank you so much for watching this today. I hope you're working in your sketchbook and growing as an artist. And till next time, happy crafting!